Unless you've been living under a rock forever, you've probably heard of Vtech. It's one of the defining features of Honda engines, and it's one of the reasons so many people love it. Without Vtech, Johnny Tran probably wouldn't have smashed Jesse's Jetta. Too soon, Junior. What's up, guys? My name is Bryce with Dust Runners Automotive Journal, and today I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about Vtech and iVTEC. Variable valve timing lift and electronically controlled, also known as Vtech, is a system that uses two separate cam lobes to optimize engine efficiency. It does this by using a cam lobe for low RPM and a cam lobe for high RPM. By using two separate cam lobes, you can optimize valve overlap, lift, and duration for two separate sets of RPM. So you end up with more low-end torque and more high-end horsepower, but you still have great drivability and great fuel efficiency. This kind of a system is usually set to engage at a set RPM, say 5,500 RPM, it will engage the second cam lobe. So Honda implements this system, and so do many other car manufacturers now, to improve overall engine efficiency. Since a camshaft spins half as fast as a crankshaft, you can really only optimize it for one set of RPMs. Now, by having two different lobes, you can optimize it for two sets. If you had three lobes, you could optimize it for three sets, and so on and so forth. But two is pretty much all you need to optimize it for low-end and high-end power. If you ever wondered why muscle cars have that really lopey idle, it's because they're using an aftermarket camshaft designed for high-end power. Now, designing it for high-end power, it's designed to have duration and lift and valve overlap specifically at high RPM. That means at low RPM, it's basically, it's not designed for low RPM at all, and that's what gives it that choppy idle. Before I tell you what iVTEC is, let me tell you what Vtec-E is, because that's a different kind of Vtec that not a lot of people even know about. Vtec-E is different in that it is not designed for power, basically at all. It's designed solely for fuel efficiency and nothing else. Vtec-E gets such great fuel economy by turning your 16-valve four-cylinder engine into a 12-valve four-cylinder engine. What it does is it doesn't allow one of the intake valves to fully open. By not allowing the second intake valve to open all the way, combustion chamber swirl is improved and so is fuel atomization. This allows Honda to use a leaner AFR and ultimately improve fuel economy. Another thing we quickly need to talk about before talking about iVTEC is VTC, which is known as variable timing control. Now, variable timing control is typically a mechanism that you'll find on the end of an intake camshaft, and it's essentially cam phasing. It allows the intake camshaft to be continuously variable so that the overlap between the intake and exhaust cam can be infinitely adjustable throughout the RPM range. This kind of system can be used on both the intake and exhaust camshaft, but for the most part, it's only used on the intake camshaft because that's where you're going to find the greatest gains. Intelligent variable timing and lift electronically controlled, which is a massive mouthful, is a system that combines Vtech and VTC into one system. As you can imagine, combining Vtech and VTC, or the best of both worlds, into one system results in a really efficient and really powerful engine. The Vtech part of the system has two different cam lobes, one for low RPM, one for high RPM, and the VTC system is constantly adjusting valve overlap to be optimized. So throughout the power band, you pretty much have optimum valve overlap, timing, and duration throughout the entire rev range. Unfortunately, Honda made this really confusing by having two different kinds of iVTEC. So in the case of the K20A2, which is the performance-oriented K20 that we got in the US, that combines Vtech and VTC. By combining those two, Honda got a lot of power out of that little engine. Where this gets really confusing is with the K20A3, which combines Vtec-E and VTC. Now, combining Vtec-E and VTC, you still get great power, but it's not performance-oriented like iVTEC and the K20A2. It's still good, but it's designed for fuel efficiency. It's really annoying that Honda decided to use iVTEC as the name for both the K20A3 and the K20A2, because really they're different systems. Now, how exactly Vtech increases horsepower can be kind of confusing if you're new to the whole automotive world. Now, horsepower is just a measure of torque times RPM. Now, to increase torque, you need to get more air into the engine, and with more air, you can add more fuel. This results in a larger combustion, more downwards force, and more torque. By opening the valves further and for longer at different rev ranges, you can ultimately increase torque at low RPM and increase torque at high RPM. The VTC system optimizes how much air is being sucked into the engine at low RPM and high RPM by constantly adjusting the cam timing. You might be wondering why Honda didn't just use more cam lobes in their Vtech system instead of just two cam profiles. They could use three or four cam profiles. And the answer is simplicity. The gains from three cam profiles would be so minuscule that it really wouldn't be worth it, especially considering it would vastly increase the complexity of the system, ultimately decreasing reliability down the road because you have more moving parts. The easiest way to remember all this is that iVTEC is the same as Vtech, except it has VTC included in the system to further improve efficiency. I hope this helped you guys understand the difference between Vtech and iVTEC better. If it did, be sure to hit that thumbs up button and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video.